फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू फिजिक्स क्लास। हियर वी डिस्कस अबाउट एटम एंड न्यूक्ली ऑफ सेकंड ईयर सिलेबस। इन दिस टॉपिक इज ऑल अबाउट थॉमसन एटॉमिक मॉडल, रदरफोर्ड एटॉमिक मॉडल, बोर एटॉमिक मॉडल एंड एटॉमिक स्पेक्ट्रा। लेट्स कंटिन्यू द थॉमसन मॉडल ऑफ एन एटम। हियर व्हाट हैपेंड इन 1988, जे.जे. थॉमसन प्रपोज दैट ऑल द पॉजिटिवली चार्ज मैटर यूनिफॉर्मली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड all over the atom, and electrons are embedded within it like the seeds in the watermelon or plums in the pudding. So this model is also known as plum pudding model. Here what happened? Mutual repulsion of electron is equal to the attraction force between the electron and the positively charged matter. So the atom is neutral or stable in the concept of Thomson atomic model. Here what happened? Thomson able to explain about the chemical reaction and radioactive disintegration. These two process they able to explain, but here some drawback, they unable to explain or fails to explain about the origin of spectral series or atomic series of hydrogen like atom. Also fail to explain the large angle scattering of alpha particle. On the basis of the alpha particle scattering in 1911, E. Marsden and H. Rigger performed the experiment on alpha particle scattering. Next, we discuss about Rutherford. On the suggestion of Rutherford, they performed experiment. So, in the next topic, we discuss Rutherford atomic model. Let's go to Rutherford atomic model. In 1911, H. Rigger and E. Marsden, on the suggestion of Rutherford, perform experiment on alpha particle scattering. He take bismuth as the source of alpha particle and take all the observation in a vacuum chamber to prevent alpha particle scattering from outside. Now, what is alpha particle? Alpha particle is a helium ion. What is helium ion? If we take a helium atom, we know that helium atom is consist of 2 proton and 2 electron, also 2 neutron. If we eliminate 2 electron from the helium atom, then it can be a positively charged particle or a positively charged ion, that is called as helium ion or alpha particle. Most of the radioactive substance can emit alpha particle. So here that observation is take on the scattering of alpha particle. Now here bismuth is placed within a thick lead block of small narrow opening, and here the source is collimated into a narrow beam. And strike the thin gold foil. The thin gold foil is thickness 2.1 into 10 to the power minus 7 meter, a single atom layer. When the alpha particle falls on the thin gold foil, it can scatter in any different direction. And which is observed by rotatable detector. That rotatable detector is consist of zinc sulfide screen. When that alpha particle strikes the zinc sulfide screen, a tiny flash is happening. That flash does not view through the normal eyes. So here microscope is there which view the tiny flash. Then this one is the actual path of the alpha particle. But if it deviates its path, at which angle it deviates its path, that angle is called a scattering angle. Now that observation is, how many number of alpha particles scattered in which angle? That means 0 to 90 degree. In between this angle, 0 to 90 degree. In between this angle, how many number of alpha particles scattering? And above 90 degree, how many number of alpha particles scattering? On the basis of this, they observe, and the observation later we discuss. Now, the observation is, depending upon the experimental data, the scattering angle along x-axis and number of alpha particle scattering, that number take as along y-axis. So here what happened, depending upon the experimental data, most of the alpha particle passes through through the gold foil stretch and small deviation occur. That is, that small deviation, that is less than 90 degree. Less than 90 degree, there most of alpha particle passes straight and small deflection occur. And in 8000 alpha particle, if we consider that 8000, in 8000 alpha particle, one alpha particle is deflected more than 90 degree. Means some alpha particle is deflected 90 degree, deflected more than 90 degree, 90 degree to above. Okay, that small alpha particle, that means 1 in 8000 alpha particle deflected more than 90 degree. And very rarely, very small amount of alpha particle rebound through the gold foil. That means it rebake and deviated nearly 180 degree, go back to the own direction. In those three assumptions, observation, the 3 points, they conclude some important fact. As most of the alpha particle passes straight and small deflection happen, so that most of the space in the gold foil is empty. Must be empty. Most of the space must be empty. Then, as small alpha particle is deviated through 90 degree, so that there must be some positive charges there. So it repel the alpha particle, and that positive charge is gathered in somewhere. And further, that last observation is, some alpha particle is go back to their own direction, deviated through 180 degree. That means the massive, that all the positively charged are concentrated at a point and they are massive gathering. That so that they finally conclude that all the positive charge is concentrated and that mass of the atom is concentrated at the core, and that core is called as nucleus. Here all the positive charge is concentrated at the central core, and that central core is called as nucleus. Now we go to, on the basis of the alpha particle scattering experiment, Rutherford proposed the following model of an atom. The first one, that all the positive charge particle is gathering at the center. The small and massive center is small and massive. That is called a central core or nucleus. Here all the positively charged particle gather. And the size of the nucleus is 10 to the power minus 10 meter, which is very less than the size of the atom. Where the size of the atom nearly 10 to the power minus 10 meter. Now that nucleus is surrounded by electrons. And the number of electrons, the number of negative charge is equal to number of positive charge. So the atom is stable. So the atom is neutral because of the number of positive charge is equal to number of negative charge. Now, what happened? As that nucleus is surrounded by electron, there must be electrostatic attraction forces there. So, if any chances that electron goes towards the nucleus? No. Here, that electrostatic attraction force act like centripetal force. So that electron revolve around the nucleus. Now, these are the concept model of an atom which is proposed by Rutherford. But here also some demerit, some drawback, that he cannot explain the stability of atom, in which path electron move. That suggests that electron is revolve around the nucleus in any orbit. As that electron is revolved in any orbit, that means its frequency continuously change. According to electromagnetic spectrum, as any particle is continuously accelerate, it emit energy. So, as that electron is continuously change its ready, so it continuously accelerated. As it continuously accelerated, it emit energy or loss energy. So, it gradually, not in a definite path, it becomes a spiral path and loses its energy and gradually collapse to the nucleus. It go through a spiral path and gradually collapse to the nucleus. So here the concept is, he cannot explain the stability of an atom. Also, that concept is, as all the electrons revolve in possible ready. All the electrons revolve in any possible ready, like any possible path or any spiral path, then they continuously emit energy. That means that arises a continuous spectrum. But in case of hydrogen-like atom, they have behave line spectrum or discrete spectrum. As all the electrons revolve in a spiral path, that means according to another proposed concept, as electrons are revolve in a spiral path, that means they emit continuous spectrum. But all the atom have discrete spectrum or line spectrum. So how is it possible? This one is the second drawback, that he cannot explain the line spectrum of atom. Okay, next one, if we consider an alpha particle, take as its mass m, okay, we consider an alpha particle, its mass m, and moving with velocity v, and move towards the nucleus. This alpha particle is a positively charged particle, and nucleus is also a positively charged. That all the massive or positive charge is gathered at this nucleus. So here some repulsion between these two positively charged. So this alpha particle go towards the center, and at a certain point it never go towards center. At a certain point it stop. This distance is called as closest approach. This distance is called as closest approach, and that is taken as R0. Now what happened? We consider an alpha particle of mass m and velocity v move towards nucleus with velocity v. That alpha particle is positively charged particle, its charge is 2e, and in case of nucleus, all the positively charged particle gather there, and that is having atomic number, take as atomic number z. So the total charge, that is z into e. If one proton having charge e, then z number of proton having charge z e. Then if that alpha particle move towards nucleus, at a certain point it becomes rest. The distance between the certain point to nucleus, that is called as closest approach, and that is denoted by R0. Then why it is at rest? Because the two particle having both similar in charge, both are positively charged particle, so they repel each other. And alpha particle goes towards nucleus, gradually its kinetic energy loss. क्योंकि क्या होता है ना, इन दोनों के बीच repulsion force है, और ये repulsion force को cover up करके आगे जा रहा है, तो obviously इसकी kinetic energy zero हो जाएगी. So here what happened, its kinetic energy gradually decreases. As we know that according to conservation of energy, the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy, that is constant. At this point, as kinetic energy is zero, then the total kinetic energy is equal to its potential energy. Because initially iski kinetic energy jo hai gradually aage badhte badhte iski kinetic energy zero ho gayi, ghat gayi, but gayi kahan? Because kinetic energy and potential energy, that is equal to constant. So as kinetic energy zero, then the total value is equal to the potential energy, so that the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy must be constant. So here the total kinetic energy is equal to potential energy of the alpha particle and the nucleus. Then what is the kinetic energy of alpha particle? We know that formula half mv square. Then what is the potential energy? That potential energy 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q1 q2 by r. So take as that q1 to q and q2, that is ze, that the charge of alpha particle and charge of nucleus, put the value ze into 2e, then the answer is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 2ze square by r0. Then what happened? As kinetic energy and potential energy similar, put the value of kinetic energy and potential energy and deduce R0. So here what happened? R0 equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 2ze square by half mv square. That means 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0, that is a constant value. Take that constant beta, and 2ze square by half mv square, that is the kinetic energy. So from this formula, we conclude that if kinetic energy of the alpha particle is maximum, then that closest approach becomes minimum, because R0 is inversely proportional to kinetic energy. So kinetic energy jitna zyada hoga, in dono ke beech closest approach utna hi kam hoga. Okay? So next we go to that Bohr's atomic model in that next clip. Thank you.